Greetings everyone, today I am going to show you how you can download models from CivitAI or Hugging Face onto the cloud services such as RunPod, such as Method Compute, such as Kaggle or Google Colab. Some models on the CivitAI requires login. I will show you how you can download those login required models. Moreover, I will show you how you can download models from private repositories of Hugging Face, including how to upload your models to the Hugging Face or download them from Hugging Face behind a private repository. So let's begin with downloading this juggernaut XL model. This is a public model. How do I know? When you right-click this download and open link in private window, you will see that the download will start. Yes, as you are seeing. However, some models, such as this model, is behind login. So when I do the same operation, it will not work. As you will see right now, yes. So first, let's download the public model, right-click and copy link address. This is on RunPod interface. Go to the folder wherever you want to download. Let's download into the models, into the stable diffusion folder. This is where we put. By the way, this logic applies to every file. The logic is just not for models for stable diffusion. You can download any file that you can download with a URL. So we are going to use wget command. If this command is installed on your system, this is installed in almost any Linux system, you can use it. Then put double quotation marks and paste the link like this. Then if you want to give a certain name, file name, you need to do dash big O and in the double quotation mark type the file name. Let's say the file name will be like this. Let's copy this, paste it, and the extension save tensors, and then just hit enter and it will start downloading the model into this folder as you are seeing right now. So this is the way of downloading files which are public. So let's copy this link and let's do the same thing on Method Compute. So wherever you want to download, open that folder. Let's open the folder of the stable diffusion. It is inside apps. This is my virtual machine, inside stable diffusion web UI, inside models, inside stable diffusion. I will open a new terminal here and then I will just copy paste it like this and it will start downloading the model file into here with the accurate name. Okay, let's do the same thing on Google Colab. So let's reconnect and also do on the Kaggle notebook. Let's start the session. Okay, session started. Let's generate a folder, mkey directory, and let's say test one. So this will be the directory where I want to download. Where is this directory generated? It is generated inside here. You see test one. And you can copy its path from here like this. So you see this is the default folder content of the Google Colab. Let's move inside this directory, for example, cd content test one. And now we are inside that directory. So to download it with the wget command, I will copy this command from here. Let's copy it and then put a exclamation mark and then paste it and then just execute this cell. Why we put this is necessary when you are running wget command on the Google Colab. Same applies for the Kaggle notebook. So let's generate a directory here as well, test one, and let's generate it. And the directory generated. So where is this directory? This directory is generated under Kaggle working directory. You see here. So to move there, we can use cd. This is how the cd works on Kaggle. Okay, we will say Kaggle working test one like this and then just execute and we are moved to there. Open a new interface. We use the exclamation mark here as well, then just execute and the model will get started to download it into here, into the test one folder. Kaggle provides 20 gigabyte working directory. You can see it here, and also it provides 70 gigabyte temporary directory. So if you want to generate temporary directory and use the temporary disk space, it is like this mkey directory, and then you will type the full path like this, Kaggle temp, and let's say test one. This time we need to put another command here, dash p, like this, and it will generate this directory, and it is generated. Then we can move inside there, cd kaggle temp test one, like this, and move there, and we move it there. Then we can execute this command, and it will download this model into the Kaggle temporary test one directory. So this is how the Kaggle directory is working. On the Google Colab, there is no such thing. It directly gives you 100 gigabyte disk space, as you are seeing right now, and you can see the files here. For Kaggle, you cannot see the temporary files in here, unfortunately. So you need to keep in mind wherever you have saved it and how to use them. Okay, now, what about downloading from the Hugging Face? If this is public repository, all you need to do is move wherever the file that you want to download. Let's say we want to download Realistic Vision version 2.0. So you see there is a directly download link here. Right click and copy link address. Then all you need to do is wget and paste the link like this. Again, I suggest you to use double quotation mark like this, double quotation mark, and delete this download part like this. So it is like this. This is the full file path. Then you can give a name, let's say dash O, big O, and double quotation mark. And let's give a new name, Realistic Vision 6.save tensors, because this is the extension, and just copy this. So everything is same as the downloading from CivitAI. Open a new terminal from here, wherever the folder that you want to download, paste it, and it will get downloaded with the name that you provided. It is same on the method compute as well. Just paste it and then hit enter, and it will get downloaded. The method compute download speeds are amazing. On the Google Colab, same. Just delete this and paste it like this. You see, this is the format. By the way, on Google Colab, we need to put the exclamation mark like this, and then it will work. And yes, it started downloading. On the Kaggle notebook, again, same. Just paste it, put the exclamation mark to the beginning, and hit enter, and it will start downloading. Wget command doesn't work in the Windows by default. So on Windows, you just need to click the links to download them. Let me demonstrate. So when I click this link, it will start downloading the module immediately like this. Or in here, just click this and it will start downloading the module. Okay, so what about the module that is behind login for the CivitAI? So we right click and copy link address, and then I will just replace this link with that to test. So this is the link, and let's say this is this module. Okay, I'm going to give the name like this and just copy this. And then when I paste it here, let's see what happens. Okay, I copy paste it, and you see I get unauthorized. So how am I going to fix that issue? To fix that issue, go to your CivitAI profile here. You need to have registered and login. It is free. Go to the account settings, then go to the very bottom of here, and you will see API case. Click add API key, and let's give a name test like this. And this is your API key. Copy it. Don't forget to copy. Then go back to your download link like this. Put a question mark, type token, then this equal, and paste your token. So this is the format. You see, question mark token equal my token, the API key. Then just copy it. And then let's return back to the RunPod. Let's open a new terminal, paste the link, and this time it should work. And yes, you see, we are able to download that module onto the RunPod. It will work with the method compute as well. Let's just paste it, and it started downloading. Moreover, on the Google Colab, it still should work. So let's just delete this and put a exclamation mark and just play. And you see it is downloading. Let's try it on the Kaggle as well. Let's just put a exclamation mark and play, and it started downloading. Okay, what about the Hugging Face private repositories? Because let's say you uploaded your models into a private repository and you don't want to make it public. So there are two ways. For example, this repository of me is currently private. I will make it public for a moment to start downloading. This is easier way. Let's just make it public. And then you see the download links are here. Just right click, copy link address. Let's paste it here. Okay, let's say wget, double quotation marks like this. Don't forget to delete this part. Then let's give a name, my model, save tensors. Okay, then copy it, go to the RunPod terminal, paste it, and it started downloading. After the download starts, you can make it private again, and it will continue downloading as suppository. You see, the download is working. So this way, you can minimize the risk of your models getting exposed, and you can easily download them on Kaggle, on Google Colab, on RunPod, or on Massive Compute, wherever you want. However, if you don't want to expose it at any cost, and if you have hundreds of files that you want to download from the Hugging Face repository, I have prepared an amazing notebook file. So this notebook file is shared here. Just click the attachment here, download. This notebook file also works on Windows as well, I will show. So to use this notebook file, upload it anywhere into the RunPod interface, in the JupyterLab interface. Okay, after uploading the notebook file, double click and open it. The instructions are so easy. Just click this cell. You will see that it is busy while executing, so wait until the busy is not anymore. You can also see the status here, so it has been installed. Then click this cell. If this cell gives you error like in this RunPod, it is not an issue. First of all, let's go to your Hugging Face tokens. Let's make a new token. Let's say test like this. Let's give a read and write so we can also upload. Then copy this. Go back to here. You must have logged in your Hugging Face account, then replace the token here. Just play this cell and wait. Yes, it is now done. Then you can download the entire repository from here. First of all, let's try downloading my private repository, which is here. Copy this from there. This is the repository name. Wherever you want to download them, I want to download them inside this folder. So to inside there, I will right click and copy path. On RunPod and also on Kaggle, you need to put a backslash to the beginning like this, and I am ready. Then I will just execute this cell and it will start downloading all of the files one by one, like I am downloading into my computer. You see, it started perfectly fine. The logic is same wherever you are using. So let's also try to upload a file as well. To upload a single file, we will use this cell. To upload a folder, we will use this cell, but I suggest you to use this one for uploading. This supports resume as well, so you can resume with this way if something interrupts. So these are the cells to upload and download. Make sure that you did set the full paths accurately and the repository names accurately and the file name accurately if you are uploading a single file. If you are uploading a folder, make sure that your folder path is accurate and your repository is accurate. So how you can use this notebook on Massive Compute? So let's copy the notebook and let's transfer it into our Mass Compute here. It is so easy. Okay, then all I need to do is I just need to start the Jupyter notebook from here. You see, it will let me select. I am going to select it inside the thin drives here, Mass Compute. This is my synchronization. You will see this in my tutorials. I already have them. So this is the file and it will get started and the steps are same. Just execute this cell. So the rest is exactly same. I'm not going to show again. Okay, now we are going to use this on Kaggle. How we are going to use? Let's open a new code. Go back here. Let's say we want to use the upload feature or download feature. Let's try download. So I will copy paste this here and execute it. If you are not able to open this like this interface, you can use Visual Studio Code. So actually I will use that to open this file. Let's go to download and open with the Visual Studio Code. Then to login, I will use this one. Let's go back to the Kaggle. The steps are same in the Google Colab as well. Let's open a new tab here. So we need to copy paste our token. Let's copy the token. Then let's paste it here. Then let's just save and it should work. Okay, it is done. I think it is done. So to download the files, we copy this download cell. The upload is also same. You just need to give accurate paths. Okay, here. Then the repo ID. So the repo ID was here. This is a private repo. Let's copy the repo ID. Let's paste the repo ID here. Okay, target folder. Now I need to give the target folder. So I will copy the directory path from here. By the way, this doesn't have much space, so it will get out of space, but it is fine. And then just let's execute this cell and it should start. Let's see. The upload is also same. Yes, it started perfectly fine. Actually, let's also see the upload. So for upload, let's use this Juggernaut Excel. So I will copy this directory and I will use the upload feature. So let's open a quote here. Let's go back to our notebook file and the upload cell is here. Let's copy paste it. Then let's copy the path. So let's delete this folder path from here. The same steps applies to the Google Colab. Exactly same steps. Okay, where I want to upload? I want to upload them into this repository. Let's say, let's copy it. Let's go back here. Paste. By the way, this is repository type is so important. This is model repository. There is also other repositories. Which other ones? When you go to your profile icon, click, you can generate model, dataset, space, collection. If you generate dataset, then you need to use dataset. Okay, we are ready. Let's play this cell. And now this cell should upload this into there. Let's see. Yes, it generated new PR. Then it will upload it and it will commit that. And we will see the file there. We have this file currently. It is not completed. Let's see. Okay, it says loading widget. Yes, it is already uploaded. And we can see that the upload is here. When we go to the files, we can see that it is uploaded here. However, this file was incomplete, so I will just delete it. This file is inaccurate. I am just showing you as a demo. So about the Google Colab, exactly same. We just open a new code. First of all, we copy this install cell. This install cell is mandatory everywhere. This is installing the necessary libraries, execute it. Then we need to set our token like we did. So open a new code here, paste it, copy your token from here. Let's copy it. Then go back to here. Let's set it. Then we are ready to download wherever we want. So open a folder path here. Let's see. This is the copy. Okay. Let's say we want to download this repository, copy it. Then this is the repository name. Okay, where we want to download. Let's say we want to download inside test one. So copy path, then just delete this folder path and copy it and just hit play and it will start. This was upload code. Sorry about that. Let's copy the download code. Okay, let's copy back again. Let's go to the here, paste it. Let's copy this again. Copy path like this. Paste it and just hit play. And it will start downloading all the models into this folder. Okay, what about using this notebook on the computer? So to be able to use it on your computer, you need to install Jupyter Notebook. Installing Jupyter Notebook requires only Python. You can see that install JupyterLab. When you click it, it will show you this link. Once you installed it, you can open your Jupyter Notebook like this. So after you open your Jupyter Notebook, everything is exactly same. I will just click upload, upload the notebook like this, click upload. Then the notebook will be uploaded. Just open it with double click and you see the same interface. It is running in Python 3. Everything is exactly same. I just execute this cell. It will install the necessary libraries. Then set your token from here. Let's set, copy, exactly same. Just execute this cell. It will be set. Then you can download, upload. You just need to set your folder paths. For example, let's give an example. Let's copy this, paste it here. Wherever I want to download, let's say I want to download into downloads folder, or perhaps let's download into R drive. Let's download into mass compute folder. This is just an example. Okay, I copied the path. I paste it like this. And when you're working with Windows, also put an R key to the front of here because it is working with Python. So it will treat this as a raw URL. And then let's execute this cell. You see, currently it is busy. I can also see the kernel is busy here. And it started downloading. You see, it is downloading with 55 megabytes per second. I can see the files are getting downloaded. So it is working exactly as should be, same as on the cloud. So I hope you have enjoyed. Please like, subscribe, share this video. And you can download the notebook here, the most advanced, newest version. I will keep updating it. The link of this post will be in the description of the video. Hopefully see you in another amazing tutorial.